my dad was a horse trainer and also a jockey, and mum was a jockey, and so I was, you know, probably in the end, you know, I wasn't really interested in racing as a kid, but once I sort of become a teenager, I had to sort of figure out what I was going to do with the rest of my life, and the professional skateboarding racket wasn't going to kick off, so I jumped on the back of the pony, and the rest is history. My dad's probably, you know, he's probably been my biggest mentor in racing, and he's sort of the first bloke I go to, when I've done something wrong, and then I give Pop a ring, and he's a lot softer. He picks me back up after the old man's tore into me.
Your sister, Caitlin, also a jockey, was a jockey. What was the sibling rivalry like there when you were riding together?
Pretty complicated, because she's still, I still looked at her as my little sister, so I was always very protective of her, and you know, it's quite a dangerous job, and it's not something you want, you know, to see happen, you know, anything bad to happen. So it was a bit complicated. Obviously, you had to be competitive, but at the same time, there was a bit of worry there, and she had a couple of bad falls, and they, you know, that wasn't great. And we were all pretty relieved once she hung the boots up. Got two young boys, and the lifestyle as for a jockey in Melbourne is hectic, and it's every day and night during the summer, and I just missed a lot of family time at home, and I just, you know, to cut a long story short, I didn't quite enjoy my job anymore down there, and I just found coming to Queensland, I was just able to achieve a better balance between, you know, I try and work as hard as I can, but it also gives me a chance to, you know, just do the little things at home that I never got to do early doors, and your kids are only young once, and I just felt like I was missing out on too much at home, and it was pretty much down to, you know, an opportunity to come up with Chris Lees, and I grabbed it with both hands and haven't looked back. You know, obviously, my first city winner for Chris Lees was a big relief for me. I, you know, he gave me a huge opportunity, and I really wanted to repay him, you know, as quick as I could. And it was just a midweek race at Doomben, and it was just like, it felt like winning a Group One. You know, I was so happy to get the runs on the board so soon, and then we ended up winning a black type race with Miss Fabulous, and that was just the icing on the cake. You know, that I think that gave me a lot of confidence riding here, you know, with all the boys in the, you know, metropolitan area, and I can't thank Chris enough for the opportunity he presented to me, and I really enjoy working for him, and you know, that's one thing I really wanted to, you know, it's been really fulfilling, is, you know, repaying the faith.
By half a length, the Wren's Day is coming home strongly along the inside. And then Lord Tropicana, a gap the Pride of Kalaroo, and Girl You Want. But Wren's Day, the odds-on favourite, hit the front and takes the lead from Samaze, who's very game on the outside. Wren's Day and Samaze. Wren's Day by a half length. And Wren's Day, one of three parts Samaze.
Yeah, I was really happy with him the other day. I think sort of going out to the 1400 is going to further improve him, and he's drawn a nice gate, and I expect him to get a nice run and run really well.
A length and a half to Prometheus, and further out to Mangione, but Milkman down the outside, Top Prospect the inside. Milkman's got the lead. Top Prospect tries, 150 metres left to go. Milkman, Top Prospect the inside, Top Prospect, Milkman, Top Prospect, Milkman, Milkman kicks in, Milkman!
Yeah, he showed a lot of improvement the other day. I think he's a horse that when he first got up here, he came up from Newcastle and probably just needed to settle in. And I think he's improved a lot now that he's been here and been in the stable for a little while. And he showed sharp improvement last start, so I'm expecting him to sort of carry on and go that way.
Sook Windeled narrowly. The inside is Vincere Valare. Let's hear again Puppet Master. Further out to Agra Vapor. Vincere Valare has driven through and dashed straight past Sook Winder. Further out to Let's Hear Again Puppet Master. Stella Powers over on the inside. Agra Vapor down the outside, but it's all Vincere Valare. And Vincere Valare bolts him.
Really like this mare. She's shown a lot of ability as a young horse, and she brained them the other day on a soft track, and she's a mare that I've got plenty of time for, so I expect her to be running really well at Ipswich.